you woke up this morning and you follow the New York Post on Twitter, you might have been a little bit surprised by what you saw. Their tweets included things like, "We must assassinate AOC for America." Okay. Zeldin, Lee Zeldin, candidate in New York, says, I'm not gonna read the actual message, but it's claims that he is going to sexually assault Kathy Hochul, who he's running against. They have a tweet quoting Governor Greg Abbott saying, "I will order Border Patrol to start slaughtering illegals." And they also have Lee Zeldin making racist remarks about Eric Adams. Chris Rufo, the guy who invented all the groomer stuff, saying we must destroy and imprison union teachers. Claims that they need to murder Joe and Hunter Biden. Now, they didn't actually send these out intentionally. They say that they have been hacked and they're investigating the cause. And I have seen more recent updates saying that they think a disgruntled employee was responsible for this. Now, they didn't send these out, and anybody can be hacked. They're not responsible for the fact that they got hacked. They're the victim here. But also, some of those aren't super far off from stuff that they would have rolled out anyway. I mean, have you followed the New York Post? Their stuff is wild. No, they're not gonna openly say we should assassinate AOC, but they've been fear-mongering about AOC for literally years. The stuff about Greg Abbott is like, it's like a slightly weaker verb away from being any random thing that he would actually say. And again, they're not responsible for this. And I'm not saying that I think a lot of people were fooled into thinking that these were true. I hope that that's not the case. I hope that the tweets are crazy enough that they wouldn't believe that. But I also think, I don't know, like the fact that the Rufo one says we must destroy and imprison union teachers, that could totally be a thing that he says. And so this is to me a learning moment about how extreme the other side has gotten. And maybe for the New York Post to think a little bit about how they present news. Again, they're the victims here, they're not responsible for this, but that doesn't mean it can't be an opportunity to learn a little bit.
I mean, let's hope that they learn. And it's like the headline about my governor, Governor Greg Abbott, that one was kind of scary because I don't know, like he said some pretty crazy things, especially about immigrants down at the border. And it is plausible, if you already believe in a lot of those things, then it's plausible that he also said that. It's just every time they say one thing, the next thing they have to say has to be a little bit more dramatic, a little bit more intense. And eventually you could kind of get to that point where you're calling for assassinations and things like that. But a side effect of these sorts of stunts and hackings is that it actually discourages people who might actually be bright and intelligent and motivated to get involved in the democratic process. People, stunts like this are not going to entice people to run for public office. It's a bully tactic, and unfortunately, it's an effective one. And on top of that, the average citizen, as you said, they already have a hard time distinguishing between what's real and what's fake on the news and on social media, especially on Twitter of all places. And you know, good for the Post for deleting the tweets and for disclosing the hack. But this is kind of how conspiracy theories are made. If something can possibly happen, then the people who are already paranoid are more likely to believe that it is happening and that it's happening all the time, or at least whenever that particular narrative is convenient for whatever theory that they are proposing at the moment.
Yeah. And the only other comment I'll make about the conspiracy theory is I saw replies to their tweet saying that these were hacks, they didn't send these out. And already you had right wingers claiming that this is a Democrat plot to make it seem as if there's more racism than there actually is. And maybe it is a Democrat. It's possible. We live in a complex universe. I can't predict literally everything. But when someone chooses to take over an outlet to make racist remarks, to call for the death of AOC and Joe Biden, I don't think we should instantly assume that it's a strong lefty that's doing that. Maybe the sort of person that would tweet racist things is racist. I know it's wild, but maybe that's a demonstration of racism and not actually proof that racism doesn't exist. I don't know, maybe something to think about.
Yeah, what a weird like yarn on the wall kind of conspiracy that would be if it was a leftist who was doing any of this.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.